second consecutive year that the Japanese pair have been in the quarterfinal of this Malaysian Open. A year ago, they lost out to Chai Biao and Jiang Nan. Of course, we've already seen Jiang Nan earlier today in the mixed doubles, where he and his partner Zhao Yunlei lost out to the Danish combination. So, Japanese pair wanting to do one better than they did a year ago. The Malaysian pair, first time that they've played the Malaysian Open as a combination. Mohd Zakry Abdul Latif getting this quarterfinal underway. First time that these two pairs have met each other in international competition. Japanese combination formed their partnership at the beginning of 2009. When S.Sato retired from singles. So he did make a brief reappearance in singles in this very stadium, didn't he, at the Thomas Cup finals last year. Successful he was too. Seem to remember S.Sato beating a certain Mohammed Hafiz Hashim in three games, and that really was a big part of Japan actually beating Malaysia 3-2 in the group stage of those Thomas Cup finals. And of course, thinking back to those Thomas Cup finals, it was the start really of demise of the partnership of Latif and Mohammed Farazi Zuan, Mohammed Tazari. It was their match against Japan, and Tazari had a little bit of an incident, a disagreement with somebody in the crowd. And since then, well, pretty much since then, this has been the new Malaysian pairing.
Service over. 4-3.
Oh, that's a great interception from Latif. Of course, he was a quarter finalist at this particular event in 2006, playing with Tazari.
Five,
87 in the world rankings, the Malaysian pair. It's all very fast and furious at the moment.
Yes, I think that'll be the pattern for this match, to be honest. I don't think either pair will be wanting to lift the shuttle. I think they'll both be trying to drive the shuttle whenever they get the chance. Japanese pair probably the more comfortable pair in defence. On the Malaysian side, they'll be looking to work Hoon Tian Hao into that front court position where he does read the game very, very well.
Oh, that's going wide. And that's gone long. Push to the mid-court area. What it deserved from Sato. 14 career singles titles for Sato. Last of them, the Canadian Open in 2008. Was a very fine singles player. Made a good transition into doubles.
He's a good match player. He was always a good tactical player in singles, and he's translated that well into doubles. As we can see, he brings good physicality to the game there. Very good move around the court.
Oh. Yeah, good judgment too. It's the Japanese combination that had the advantage going to the mid-game interval. 3-point advantage, to be precise. And we've only had 6 minutes of play. All happening in double quick time. But just picking up on a point you made there, Ian, about the physicality of the Japanese players. They're very agile, very quick around the court. And the Malaysians, in contrast, seem very solid athletes, and perhaps the mobility, especially of Hoon Thien Hao, brought into question a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, there's a real contrast here with Sato with his singles skill and singles footwork. Very, very mobile around the court. And N.Kawamae also has played a lot of singles in his earlier career. So you've got two very mobile Japanese players, whereas the two Malaysian boys were double specialists from a very young age and slightly less agile, shall we say, than the Japanese boys.
We had a quick glimpse there of Rexy Manaki. Malaysian doubles coach, former Indonesian player, former world and Olympic champion. Oh, that's clever. Good attacking play from the Japanese combination.
Service over. Yeah, very patient, Mojo. Not forcing anything. Happy to play the rallies out. Probably feel they have a physical advantage, as you were saying. And they're not scared of playing 6-7-8 smashes to create the opportunity rather than going for one big winner.
Low serve is short. Of course, Zakry was bronze medalist at the World Championships in 2009 with Tazari.
There's a good example of the lack of mobility from Hoon there. It was quite a good service from his partner, but very flat-footed there with the deep push to the rear corner. Very slow off the mark.
Oh. Showed great potential, didn't he, Hoon, as a youngster, 2004 World Junior Champion with Tambun Hyong, but to me has never really translated that potential into the sort of results that all Malaysian fans would have hoped that he would have achieved. Yeah, double hit.
Yes, he's a very good reader of the game, but yeah, you have to question his physical condition for playing at the very highest level. Really, he was given a bit of a lifeline after that Thomas Cup incident, where he was given a slightly better partner and has got a second chance. You would expect him to be very, very motivated to take that opportunity, but I have to say, as you say, Joe, you'd have to question his physical condition.
Example of what you were saying just a little earlier. Two shots he was asked to play from the back of the court, and because the first one came back, tries to make the second one a little too tight to the net and makes the error.
Yes, and the Japanese will feed on those sorts of points. They'll be very, very solid. They'll be looking to get mistakes from their opponent, and that will really encourage them, that type of rally.
Oh, that's well reached. It's fantastic rally from N.Kawamae and Sato.
Yeah, and a great example of the mobility of the Japanese players there. During the rally, both of them were in the net position, both forced out defence. Both of them very comfortable all around the court.
5-point cushion now for the Japanese pair. I can certainly understand why the Malaysians spit the pair of Tazari and Zakry Abdul Latif. But in all honesty, I don't see this combination, Malaysian combination, winning necessarily medals at world championship level, which is what Tazari and Zakry did. Pushed it long.
Yes, I tend to agree with you, Jill. What Malaysia have got is that they've got a very good group of young doubles players coming through. And I noticed in the Asian Games they've started to select one or two of them for the national team, one or two younger pairs. And they've shown real potential recently, some of the backup players in the Malaysian squad. Unfortunately, there appears to have been a mistake with the entries here, and one or two of those pairs weren't actually entered. A clerical error on behalf of the Badminton Association of Malaysia.
Yes, I understand that is the case. Of course, they would have been in the qualifying event. They wouldn't have got straight into the main draw. Their rankings aren't high enough. It does seem real tragedy that the opportunity is missed to play against some of the world's best players.
19-12.
Well, now, Japanese combination. Just 2 points away from the opening game. Oh, it's called long.
Service over. 13-19.
Oof, my goodness. Oh, oof. Well, that certainly wasn't out. We have the privilege of seeing it again, of course.
Oh.
Thien's clever return against this player, I have to say. Just a little hold deception and quick flick into the rear corners. Neither of the Malaysian boys are very quick with that first step.
Six game points. Oh, that's a glorious shot.
Service over, 15-20.
Yeah, lovely touch here, feinting the smash, the big wind-up, the big preparation. Lovely change of direction and pace.
For the flick serve is long of the double service
first
line.
Game won by Naoki N.Kawamae, Shoji Chato, 21-15.
21-15 to N.Kawamae and Sato of Japan. And the home players are going to have to lift their game if they want to come through this quarter-final encounter. Well, Park Jubong, the coach, taller of the two coaches there, offering advice. He himself, former World and Olympic champion, former Korean player. In England, coaching spell in Malaysia, now in Japan, and everywhere he's been, he's made a huge impact. The results of players, Japanese team, players doing well in general terms. So the Malaysian pair of Mohd Zakry Abdul Latif and Hoon Thien Hau, now still communicating well. That's a very good sign for Malaysian fans. But the Japanese combination of N.Kawamae and Sato, just too much attacking power and attacking play in that opening game.
Service over, one, love.
Good serve, rack it up ready to intercept the third shot. Classic doubles tactics. Goodness. Well, considering he took it so late, that was a wonderful cross-court shot, but Sato was equal to it. Look how he's launching himself forward, racket arm outstretched, still taking the shuttle, coming over the top of the shuttle rather than coming underneath it, keeping on the attack. Wonderful play from Shoji Sato.
Yeah, again, another example of what ex-singles players can bring to doubles. Really good physicality, great footwork there. And I don't know if you noticed, he's actually recovered into court in case the next one came back. Really good balance.
Three, two.
just sensational. Goodness me.
That's really good touch around the front court there, but you have to say when you're out of position, as Sato was there, it's very dangerous to play straight because it makes you, means your partner's got to cover a lot of court. There, here, normally, from a coaching perspective, you want him to be playing that block into the middle rather than straight.
Service over, 3-0.
Just maybe signs of a lack of experience on the doubles court there, but... Oh. Makes up for it with his mobility, as we saw in the next point there.
4-3.
Neither of these pairs have ever been in a semi-final of a Super Series event. This is a big, big match as far as both pairs are concerned. Pushed it wide.
It's good movement from the Japanese. Neither of them are very aggressive front court players, but what they do is they take a position very high on the court so they don't leave space on the front court for their opponents to take advantage of.
Rexy Maneki on the right. Rosman Razak on the left.
Malaysian favoured combination there, Hoon getting in and getting the block in, forcing Sato to take the shuttle from below the net and forcing the mistake. Defense, I'd have to say. It was right into his favourite zone on that backhand defense and complete mishit.
Japanese pair really are trying to expose the frailties in Hoon Tian Hao.
Slow off the mark, that hold, return of serve and the flick into the backcourt, and Hoon not able to push off quick enough to cover the deep return.
Yeah, another error from Hoon's racket. Good play.
Service over, 7-9.
Did well to get out of the way. There, yeah, the back level.
A little variety on service. Using the flick serve for the first time. The Japanese off balance. Proactive in the front court there, early on the net once. He's looking for the interception to finish. That's good anticipation.
So four straight points for the Malaysians. Take them into the lead.
Difference a little bit. Just let the shuttle come to him there rather than stepping forward onto this. Rather than stepping forward onto the midcourt to play that cross block, just let the shuttle come to him. That gives the Japanese players to move forward and be aggressive on the front court.
But it's the Malaysians who have the advantage at the mid-game interval. The slenderest of possible margins, just 1 point in it.
That it's Hoon that's getting all the advice from Rexy there, concentrating very much on Hoon there. Just signs there that the Malaysian boys were just getting a little bit more positive and getting a little bit of confidence in the front court to actually be more aggressive.
Thank you. Ready, please.
So the umpire asking the players to get ready. 11-10, second game. Go! Japanese pair having taken the first though. Oh my goodness. Trying a deceptive, almost top spin shot there, Hoon Thien Hao. Yes, he's still so quick, isn't he, Sato?
Keeping it very simple, just playing the block. Malaysians not wanting to lift and just making the error.
Fast again.
13, 12.
Never lacks commitment, does he, Sato?
No, he's a good match player. Good match player in his singles days. He liked, he relished the 19-all, the 20-alls. He's never scared of the big points.
Well, 14, Japanese pair on a run of four straight points. And there's a little spring in the set now of Sato. Point for the Malaysians.
Yes, it was, and I'm sure how well the Malaysians are thinking. Sato won almost 4 points on his own there, and the first time they've gone passed him to his partner. His partner made the mistake.
That's a good low serve.
14, four.
Couldn't attack it. N.Kawamae. Two consecutive errors on the return of serve. One from each of the Japanese players. And it's the Malaysians back into the lead.
It's Sato who's the dominant player. He's looking to move in all the time. Very positive in the front court. Malaysians being driven off the net. See how deep they are with their defensive position there.
Crowd really trying to get behind the home players.
Across the rear court, just a little bit late. So he's having to do the full width and he's really late.
That's a good call by the line judge.
Yeah.
Every point so precious at this stage in a game.
Thinking bringing the block into the middle of the court just to set the play up. Just got the extra bit of luck with the net cord.
Play, please.
That was that little shot you were talking about earlier. Guide it to the centre of the court rather than playing it straight. Good rally.
Nervy from the Malaysian players again though. They had three or four chances to finish that. Yeah, and good patience though, drove the Japanese off the net.
Yeah, once again his lack of mobility at the back of the court, moving from side and deep into those back corners, really exposed as a weakness by the Japanese pair. As far as the Malaysians are concerned, there's no doubting the natural talent of Hoon Thien Hao. If he was to get himself into really good physical condition, he could be a very good pair. All. Oh, well, how many points have been won by Shoji? Sato going forward to the net, really launching himself again, just leaping forward, taking the shuttle early, making the difference. 2 points away from their first ever semi-final in Super Series events. Now just the one.
20 match points.
Two match points for the Japanese pair. Smashes.
Yeah, good angle to the centre of the court there.
250 kilometres an hour. That's 155 miles per hour. Goodness me. Fastest of the match so far.
Light planes.
Said he didn't hold back. Still match point for the Japanese pair, though. And this time they convert, and how fitting that it was Sato who finished it off. He was absolutely outstanding in this quarter-final. And the crowd not happy seeing their men defeated, but it was much more attacking play, an effective play by the Japanese combination. 21-15, 21-19.
Yeah, really interesting there, Jill. But the deciding factor was very much the front of the court. Sato getting in and winning a lot more points from the front court, whereas the Malaysian pair were very hesitant in the front court, not as aggressive. And Sato used his mobility to good effect and was very, very positive on the front court.